Hey guys, welcome back. It's day 47. Yesterday we were talking about how to make sure your contacts are safely stored. And the answer to that was to save them in your email accounts. That way, if you lose your phone or your SIM card, you are not out of luck. But it begs the question, what if you can't get into your email account? For this reason, you want to be sure to always have a alternate method to get back into your email. Providers like Apple and Gmail and Microsoft will always give you the option to recover to a backup email account. Or nowadays, you'll find that they all offer Multi Factor Authentication, also known as MFA or 2FA for Two Factor Authentication. What does that mean? Multi Factor, Two Factor. That means that if you can't get into your email or your other email address, then there's going to be another way to access your account, and that's either a text message sent to your device or another application that is previously downloaded on your phone, like LastPass or Microsoft's Authenticator app, and it will give you an authentication code that you can then enter into the recovery page so that you can get into your email address. And I get it, it sounds complicated. Why so many devices? Why so many methods of getting into your password and your account? It's overwhelming and it can be too much. But if you make it simple, just remember that you're making it simple for everyone else, not just you. Anyone that's maliciously trying to access your email, your contacts, your information that you have stored in there, it will be much easier for them to guess your password and then also not have to authenticate with another device. Having more than one factor authentication really just prevents that everyone that is accessing your info is authorized to do so. I wouldn't say that multi-factor is needed on everything, but I would definitely consider it on your bank accounts. Anything that has financial information that's really important to you. This unfortunately does take some setup time, and whenever you change over to a new device, it does require some refreshers. But just keep in mind that you can always mark your personal computer or your personal phone as a trusted device so that it doesn't always ask you to multi-factor authenticate. Consider how important your information is to you and to others, and definitely take a look at multi-factor when you have a chance. Stay safe and secure, guys. Keep teching. Peace.